you can't get enough of Rainier Avenue Radio. Dot world.
You know you can't get enough of that Rainier Avenue Radio, and you're going to get it all day long right here on Make Music Day Seattle 2020 live broadcast for you. The lessons continue for you. Now we go live with Julian Catford with some virtual guitar lessons.
Morning or afternoon. How you doing?
Good.
So have you played guitar before at all?
No.
Okay, have you played music before, anything kind of music?
Flute. I played flute, and I tinkered on the piano a tiny bit.
So you'll be great. So I'm going to do, you know, I realized in thinking about this class, I'm addressing you, but I'm addressing the internet out there as well, and everybody who might be listening, you know.
Okay.
So I'm going to cover beginning guitar. I can't show you how to play the guitar in 1 hour, but I can get you started in the right track, and I got a great PDF you have access to on their website, and I'll be accessing some of those things and sharing a screen with you and stuff like that. Yeah, but I've been teaching for decades. So here, we'll do some basic things for beginning guitar. First of all, the parts of the guitar, okay? Just to be, you know, quick. So I'm going to go kind of quick, and you can come back. They're recording it, and you can go back over this stuff later. Your guitar is kind of like a person. It's got a body, a neck, a head. It has the six strings, obviously. This is the bridge. They call this the saddle. And classical guitar, en español, la boca de la guitarra is the mouth of the guitar. We call it the sound hole, of course. But it does make it more like a person. And then this little guy here is the nut. And then these are the tuning pegs or tuning machines, they're sometimes called. And then you have frets, 1, 2, 3, 4. The frets are these little pieces of wire put into the fingerboard, they call this. And the first fret is the first piece of wire, but the playing area you're going to put your finger in. And most important to me is that if you can sit back a little bit, then I can see both of your hands, especially your left hand, but both hands. We're going to do some finger style things, and then I'll talk about playing with a pick as well. So the first fret is this playing area, second fret, third fret. The sound is kind of bidirectional. We have low or bass sounds on the fat string near your face, and high strings. Any strings are high in pitch. Okay, that's the guitar itself. You want to sit in such a way that you can hold the guitar and your hands are free to play. That's the thing. You know, you're not holding up your guitar. So usually that works by resting the curvy bit of the guitar on one's right leg if you cross your leg. And if you have a steel string guitar, a lot of times you can attach a strap if you like. A classical guitar, you tend to sit in a different posture. I play a lot of classical, but most people have steel strings, so that's what we're doing here. So, okay, right hand. The fingers are named we're going to do finger picking initially, sort of folk guitar, basic stuff, and then we'll do some strumming and things. The right hand, P-I-M-A, from the Spanish names of the fingers, pulgar, índice, media, annular. Think Pima, P-I-M-A, and this is all on the PDF that you'll get. Index middle. It's rude to point a finger at someone, but there, index finger is I. That's the main thing you want to get in your brain right now. Okay. And the left hand is 1, 2, 3, 4. We don't count the thumb. Left hand, 1, 2, 3, 4. We don't count the thumb on the left hand. Okay. So you piano players, I know you're used to numbering this digit, but we're not using it, so to speak. Okay. And then you want to rest your right arm kind of on the edge of your guitar. Everybody has different proportions. So, you know, you need to get it where it's kind of hanging floopy in front of the sound hole. This is a pretty big guitar, so I might not put my leg up. And I got to remember, if I want to use the computer, I have to scoot forward and then back. But, you know, so you want to kind of rest your arm and let your hand float in front of the sound hole. And we're going to pick an upstroke with our index finger. And I'm going to rest my thumb on the sixth string, but it's only resting there to keep my hand close. It's not resting there the support comes from the arm on here. That's what I'm trying to emphasize. It's kind of lightly touching there, just to stay close in. So that's our first string, E. Okay, and when you pick, let's see if this shows up. Haha. There's a line on my finger. I'm getting the end of my finger. Now, I have long nails, and that can help you play. I'm getting some finger flesh and a little bit of nail. It's not all nail. If you don't have nails, then okay, most people don't. And by the way, so ladies got to cut the nails on the left hand. If you have, you know, beautiful nails, have to cut the nails on the left hand when you make the chords and notes. You've got to have no nails. It's not going to work. And if you can, and guys, if you can grow some nails on the right hand, then they'll work like picks for you. That being said, if you don't have any nails, it doesn't really matter. I mean, it's useful, but not essential. Okay, and then our left hand, this maze, I always do this with some of the guitar classes I've taught at Seattle Pacific University for years. You're going to think I'm crazy. Well, I'm a musician, so that may be true. But make me a little left hand. Hello, kids. Make me a little puppet mouth here. Okay, hi. Okay, what this is it's important. Your thumb is vertical and your fingers, and your thumb is opposite your second finger. So the thumb isn't going off to the side. That's a big mistake everybody makes. And then they wonder why their fingers can't reach. You're limiting your reach on your left hand. So just think of the silly puppet mouth, and then your thumb is in the right place pretty much, and you put your hand up to the guitar, and your thumb, you know, you'll be in about the right place. Yeah, and then it can kind of curl around a bit, okay? But, you know, it's just that's good. And then for notes, we're going to play a few notes to get the fingers moving, and then we'll go and do some chords once we get a little coordination into the fingers on the left hand we're talking. So the fingers on the left hand are going to each initially play one finger per fret, meaning I got my first finger in my first fret, my second finger, if it's going to play, is going to go in the second fret, and my third finger or ring finger in the third fret, right? We're not even going to use our pinky initially, so don't. Pinky, fourth finger, right? I like to call it the pinky. Don't ask me why. So the musical notes, we're not going to do music reading here, although any music background that you have had previously can apply. It can be useful. You know, so if you've played any instrument or done even recorder in sixth grade, whatever, if you remember a few rudiments of music, those little things can all help you get a grasp of another instrument if you've not played guitar. So the music notes are A, B, C, D, E, F, G. We're not going to cover reading music here. We're going to play some things, but we're not going to cover reading. So the music notes from low to high always go, you know, A, B, C, D, E, they always go from low to high. So if I play this here, that is a C scale. I start on C and I go C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, C, D, and it goes low to high. So we're gonna learn the notes initially on each string, and then we're gonna combine them into something. So open is no finger down on the left hand. Open E. Why don't you pluck me your E? On the first string, which is the skinny string, the sixth string, let me clarify that. Yeah, the strings are numbered 1 through 6 with the skinny string near the ground. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The fat string near your face is what we call low E, and this other one is high E. When I'm playing single notes, I want to use my fingers initially and not my thumb. But if I'm playing a bass part, I might use my thumb. So it's kind of a double standard, okay? For single notes, we're just gonna use fingers. So on our skinny first string, we're gonna play open E, first finger, first fret, right on the fingertip. And I've got another screen here, so I'm gonna look at it, I can see you better, you know? You're good. First finger, first fret, F. And then third finger, third fret, G. Third finger, that's your second. See, you played piano, so remember, we don't count. Yeah, there you go. Third finger, and you don't need to keep that first finger down necessarily. Third, and now bend your knuckle. So you want to bend the knuckle on the left hand. Don't let the knuckles lock, because then you lose control. So see if you can, so your third finger, bend it at the knuckle near the nail. There, that's getting better. And the more you play, if you've never done this, it's kind of weird. So I'm going to play the stuff, and if I hear you or not, doesn't really matter. You can kind of get the idea, and then we'll move on. So I'm going to cover quite a bit of stuff today. You're okay so far?
Yep.
And I'm Julian. What's your name?
I'm Barbie.
Barbie. Okay. Yep. And you're looking at, you're watching on an iPhone?
I am.
It's pretty small. It's a big one.
I know. The biggest thing I have right now.
You know, they're very kindly going to video this and record it, and then they're going to post it on a, probably on YouTube or something. So you can always go back and go, what was he saying back?
Well, it's the iPhone.
My brain turned to mush, you know.
It's the bigger, the biggest of the iPhones, thank goodness, but.
Way to go.
Yeah.
I got the big iPad too for reading music, but
okay.
So let's play E, F, and G. So open E, no fingers down. First finger, first fret, F. And third finger, third fret, G. And get near the fret. When I say near the fret, this is pretty important. You want to make sure your finger is not in back of the fret, which is more towards the headstock or the head of the guitar, but more in the front of the fret. So the string catches on the fret wire, and it's more important on the thicker strings, especially that tend to buzz. The skinny strings don't do that. So you want to play near the fret, maybe a few millimeters or a 1/16 of an inch away from the fret. And there's G. Okay. And you want to try not to lock the knuckle, but you know, it's one of these things when I'm teaching, I just keep repeating it. It's my job, and eventually you'll figure it out. So,
okay.
So now we've got the idea mechanically, and be sure to raise a hand or something if you want me to go over anything else, okay? It's a little strange on the whole Zoom thing, you know, you're not right next to me physically. So now we're going to do the second string, and that's B, C, D. So B is open. And then again, first finger, first fret is C. On the second string now. Yeah, looking good. And then third finger or ring finger, D. Third fret, third fret. There you go. And that looks good. Pick it.
Okay.
Sounds good. And if you were going back and forth between those notes, then you would leave your finger in place. It's not mandatory to leave that other finger, the first finger, down. So if that helps you, great. And if it doesn't, if it hinders you, then don't. You know what I mean? So there, let's do those again. Open B. First finger C, first fret. And third finger D.
Whoops, I did the wrong one. Oh, yeah. Whoops, I'm doing something wrong.
Are you on the second? There you go. Now you got it. Third finger D. Okay, and again, this will take time to soak in. That's what you've played other instruments. That's what practice is all about. You know, and we also have, you and I need to remember there's other people that could be accessing this later or listening, but not actively. They're listening live on a Facebook feed. So, you know, I'm also trying to address things that they might be thinking. So let's go on and do the next string. And just when you thought there was a pattern, oh, I know what I was going to say. Excuse me. You may say, well, why do I need to know the note names? But even if you're not reading music, someone may say, hey, I want to sing this song. Can you give me a G? And you're like, what? Okay, so it's useful. Musicians need to communicate. You know, that's half the fun is playing with other people, and you got to be able to communicate. So anyway, it's useful to know the names of the notes. So the third string is the G string. Okay. And just when you thought there was a pattern, there isn't. So in this case, there's only two notes on this string. Open G, third string, no fingers down. Okay. And I don't always hear you, but if you can hear me and it sounds similar, then we're good.
Okay.
I don't necessarily have to hear you, especially on the internet thing with the delay and all that. We can't really play together. That's the problem with internet music lessons. So second finger now, second fret is A. So now I'm using the second finger on the second fret. Bingo! You're good. And what you will find, if you keep that thumb about the second fret, the left-hand thumb, roughly, then all your fingers will sort of be lined up where they need to go, and you just need to move your hand onto the different strings. You don't need to move your hand this way up and down the neck, so you'll already be kind of where you want to be. You follow?
Okay.
So let's play G open. And we want to pick up with the index finger here. G open. And second finger A, second fret. Okay, we're going to move on and do a few more, and then we'll have covered our note bit, and we'll go and try some chords. Okay, so we'll do a few more. You got the idea. So now the fourth string is called the D string. It's getting deeper in pitch. Right. And then this one, we have three notes on this one, D, E, and F. And I'll show you, let me show you. D open, second finger, second fret, E, and third finger, third fret, F. So let's do D open, second finger, second fret. And if you could move a few inches over to your right, I can see your hand better. There you go. Beautiful. Second finger, E. Nice. And then third finger, third fret, same string, F. Yeah. You're doing great. We'll do a few more, and then we'll give you a little break here, okay? So D, E, F on the fourth string. Rhyme again.
Oops, I gotta find my string. Hold on. Okay.
Very nice. And finally, we might as well do them all. We've got A, B, C on the fifth string. So that's open fifth string, and that's the same frets. O to open second and third fret. So we've got open A.
Open.
And then second finger, second fret, B. And I'm still picking these with my index finger of my right hand. I'm picking all the single notes with my index finger. Second finger, second fret. I would use index unless you don't, I mean, on the right hand. Yeah. And then third finger, third fret, C. Very good. So we have A, B, C. And then finally, you can play them again. Sure. Yes, you're doing great. And then just as we played on the first string, E, F, G, with, again, we want to think open 1-3 frets. The sixth string, listen to this. We have what we call an octave. Again, you're familiar, you played flute. How many years did you play flute for?
Since I was like 12 until from fifth grade to eighth grade, almost ninth grade.
Yeah, yeah. So I mean, if you got, you know what's happening there. So we have something called octaves. This is an E. And then you might have noticed, folks, we have another E that's lower. And then we have another E. So there's more than one of the notes, and they're what we call an octave apart, which is eight notes. So when you go do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, that next from do, from that scale, they're eight notes apart, hence octave, octopus, octagon, eight. So this is also, check this out, on our first string is E, this is also an E string, and it's fingered the same way, but the notes are lower. So we've got open E, first finger, first fret, got to reach all the way across the fingerboard now, and third finger, third fret, G, E, F, and G. Okay. By the way, let me mention a couple of things. You give yourself a little break, and I'll blab for a sec. So there we've covered single notes. And the reason I do that is I want to get your left hand coordinated, some response, some sensation, you know, I'm starting to get it, my left hand, because then we're gonna go make some chords. So we want to get the fingers moving, okay? And this is a bit of a lecture lesson and a bit of a speed lesson, but it's all good stuff. Like I said, I realize I can't get you completely playing the guitar wonderfully in 1 hour, but I can certainly set you on the right path and give you resources too. So one thing, we didn't talk about tuning. So one thing that's very good, there's a free tuner app called, what is it, Guitar Tuna? Let me see what it's called again, I forgot. Just a sec. And it's, yeah, Guitar Tuna, like tuna fish, T-U-N-A. Now, of course, it's not really free, as we all know. They want to sell you something. But the actual tuner thing is free, and it's very good for beginners. It's very simple and clear, and I'm all about simple and clear. Even though this may seem overwhelming right now, because I'm going to cover a lot of stuff as much as I can in 1 hour, you know. So the tuner is really great, and it'll as you tune, the little needle moves, and when you get it in tune, it goes bing and tells you you're in tune. And the other thing is, I'll just say, that's free. It's Android and iPhone, so everyone can get one on their whatever they need, their device. And just do everything, and it shows you the pegs. Do everything slowly and gently. You don't want to break a string initially. Now, you sound like you have your guitar in tune, which is cool. You know, but just don't be cranking on these things if you've never done it. Just go gently. You don't want to be breaking a string. It's more hassle than just tuning a string. So that's one resource. Let's play a few chords. Okay, so let's go and make in this phase, I'm going to do this stuff. If you don't quite get it, I'm going to kind of keep moving anyway to some degree. So okay. Do the best you can. You can mute yourself if you like, and we can just kind of see how we go, and you can sort of do as best you can, and other folks out there too. So we're going to put our third finger, that is ring finger on the left hand, on the third fret first string. Play that G note. Sounds good. Now I'm going to brush it. So for chords, for single notes, I pick up with my index finger. For chords, I'm going to brush down like three or four skinny strings. So I'm gently resting my thumb. You can see in my right hand posture. I'm right over my sound hole. I'm not here or way back. I'm kind of just resting very lightly. Give it a shot. You are strumming a G chord. Let's hear it. So can you move back an inch or two? So now I want to see your right hand. I want to see your right hand just to see that you're strumming nicely. Yeah, keep going. Good, looking good. So one other thing to bear in mind on the strumming hand, don't let the thumb get inside the fingers. So you want to strum at 90 degrees to the strings, approximately. Again, I'm not coming out there with a T-square, but I mean...
gonna pause for a station break here on Rainer Avenue Station break! Radio.
Okay.
You've been listening to some incredible guitar lessons with the one and only Julian Catford right here on our Make Music Day Seattle 2020 live broadcast all day long on Rainer Avenue Radio, which you can listen on the Facebook Live video going on all day long, on our website at RainerAvenueRadio.world, and via the RainerAvenueRadio.world app, which you can download for free. iPhone and Android users can both do equally. Keep it locked right here. We'll be back with more guitar lessons with Julian Catford right here on Rainer Avenue Radio.
Would you like to see when your favorite Rainer Avenue Radio show comes on? Check out our show schedule, updated weekly at RainerAvenueRadio.world.
Class of 2020 graduates, we are... To the esteemed graduates of the class of 2020.
Run that back again.
When you finish high school, college, grad school, or even grade school, I mean, you're still graduating.
It just doesn't feel right.
2020 graduates, we got you. Rainier Avenue Radio celebrates your hard work while maintaining safe and social distance. Rainier Avenue Radio celebrates your
commencement.
Without the crowds, but with a lot of pomp and circumstance.
Presenting your class of 2020 graduates!
Congratulations to Brianna Gamble. Brianna is a graduate of Kennedy Catholic High School, class of 2020. Ooh. Brianna's GPA, 3.45.
Wow.
And Brianna was part of the 2019-2020 cheer squad for Kennedy High School.
You know, that shows your school spirit too.
Brianna has been a cellist for 4 years.
Awesome accomplishment.
After graduating, Brianna has decided she will go to Eastern University in Washington and major in communications.
Be there and make a difference.
Congratulations to Brianna Gamble, class of 2020, graduate of Kennedy Catholic High School. Brianna Gamble.
The Urban League of Metropolitan Seattle, empowering communities and changing lives. The Urban League has been there to serve when our community is at its lowest. It's never mattered what the crisis was.
the systemic oppression remains constant for those most vulnerable. Here at the Urban League of Metropolitan Seattle, we'll be temporarily adjusting our hours of operation and available services. If you are in need of resources, we recommend that you give us a call at 206-461-3792. To make an appointment, press 0 and speak with the receptionist. Walk-in hours will be from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. Monday through Friday. And hey, we'll gladly work with you via phone as best as we can if you're exhibiting any signs of illness to assist you with information to save your home, find you a place to sleep, or connect you to job opportunities. The Urban League of Metropolitan Seattle. That's 206-461-3792.
This is Paul Pearson, host of Star Time. And when I'm not explaining to my intern exactly what R&B is, I'm listening to RainierAvenueRadio.world.
It's 1 p.m. right here on Rainier Avenue Radio with our live broadcast of Make Music Seattle going on 2020, June 21st. Happy Father's Day to everybody. We return with more lessons from Julian Catford, who will tell you more about how to learn how to strum your guitar and play it.
Hi, I have a question, Mr. Producer. Is it possible I can share my screen?
On chat?
It's disabled.
No.
Oh, well, that's going to... I guess I'll just hold my iPad up to the camera for a second. It's going to be a little strange. That was a big part of my plan. But that's okay. Onward. Okay, so we're back. And one thing, I did check with the good folks at Rainier Radio, and they did say that they would make my PDF, a handout, which is about 13 pages, so obviously it's more like a book, make that available. And if it isn't, you can contact them, and I'll be happy to send it to anybody who wants it, because I want to get this info out there. Okay, now we're going to try and do some chords. We got some notes happening. We got our coordination. We got familiar with the instrument a bit. So we're going to do a few simple chords, and if I can get you doing a couple more chords, we can get you on the road to doing a 12-bar blues. That's my plan here. So let's play the G chord. It's just the third finger on the third string. So you can check your note, and then you can strum down three or four strings. You got it? Okay. Sounds good. Let's go and make a couple of other chords that maybe are harder, but I think you'll get going. And this is where I was under the impression that I could share my PDF with everybody. So I've got on my PDF, and I'll just show you how to do it. There's a chord chart like that, you know, with the basic chords. And a lot of this information is available all over the internet, of course. There's wonderful things available everywhere. And I've just consolidated some things that I like to use for teaching. So let me just talk about reading these diagrams even, because you can look these up on anywhere. You know, everybody has them. So the thick line at the top is the nut of the guitar. So that is this part of the guitar. And then on the, this one doesn't show it, but on the left-hand side is your fat string, your sixth string E. And on the right-hand side, as you're looking at these charts, would be the skinny string. So look, we're gonna try and make an A, we're gonna use more than one finger now. So let's do this. Take your second finger and put it on, just do as I do. And if you could sit where I can see your left hand again a little more, I'm sorry to keep doing that. It's just, it's helpful for me because I wanna help you. So your second finger on the second fret of the fourth string.
Okay.
I think you, and you can play that single note. If you want to check, are you in the right place? You could go. Okay, cool. Hold that there. And this is going to be hard, but just kind of go with me and let's flow through it. You know, third finger, ring finger on the second fret, second string.
Say it one more time. Go through one more time.
Third finger
yep.
on the second fret, second string.
Okay.
So second fret. Hang on. Okay. That's the third fret. That's the third fret you're on. Second fret,
okay.
on the second string. And see how this is something, a learning thing here. So see my knuckles, the last knuckle is kind of very bent and yours is locked. So you're gonna have to work on your notes and then work your hand into doing that. Now you got it, the bendy knuckle. And then we can rest our thumb here and brush down five strings, and you'll have an A7 chord, which is... And now what's going to happen, you're going to find some of the notes are muffled because your fingers aren't right on the tips. There's not very much room on a steel string guitar to get your fingers in there, and this is one of the more frustrating things for beginners. That's what you want it to sound like, A7. And it's kind of a jangly chord, but we're going to play a blues, and seventh chords are in blues a lot. And I'm trying to make these chords as easy as I can, okay? And we'll see where it gets us, okay?
Yeah. You know,
somebody may argue and say, no, there's other easier chords. And I would agree to a certain extent, but I want to give you something concrete. So that's an A7 chord. The lowest note in a chord is called its bass note or root. In this case, it is our fifth string open, and it's an A note, hence an A7. Now we can have different chord qualities, A7, A minor, A major, etc. We're just going to play A7 for now. Want to try it again? See if you can strum it again? You're looking pretty good, by the way, so I'm happy.
Thank you.
And we want to brush down with the index finger. Okay, let's say you're good. Don't lift up your hand, relax the tension, keep the shape or posture. This is another thing that's important to get your brain around on guitar. It's a shape or pattern instrument. So the shape that your fingers are in on the guitar right now, we're going to move it to different strings and it'll help us make another chord. We don't need to reinvent the wheel. We already have our fingers in the shape that we want them. We're going to move our two fingers down towards the ground, one string each. So walk your fingers down. So now you're going to be on the third and first string, second fret.
Okay.
Right now, we're almost there with the new chord. Hang on. We're going to add our first finger. We got to cram them in here. My first finger is going on the second string, first fret. And
okay.
It's going to sound like this. I'm going to strum four strings.
Nope, not doing it right.
Well, let me see your hand a little more, what am I trying to say? Face on with the guitar, not angled.
Okay.
So like more like face on, you're kind of angling it. So less of that. The other way. Yeah. And so your third or ring finger should be on the first string.
Oh, the first string.
Yes, ma'am. There you go. And then third string, and then first fingers on the second string, first fret, like a triangle shape. Very good. And you brush four strings. It's great. Hey, and no, not too bad on the buzzy, or it's not so much buzzy notes, it's more muffled notes that people get, you know. So that's excellent. So that's D7. And again, like I said, I was hoping to share this PDF with you, but it's not happening. So you just have to bear it in your mind. D7. Excellent. Lift off the first finger and scoot your fingers back up one string towards your face, and you'll have the A7 chord. And don't worry, you've got some muffly bits in there. Okay. And then the next thing, in order, keeping that kind of shaped posture idea in mind, we can jettison our ring finger and let's move our second finger up one more string towards our face. So it's your second finger. You can forget the other fingers. So just one finger, but we're going to add another finger here. So, and I'm trying to get close to the screen. My second finger is on the fifth string, second fret. My first finger is now going to go first finger on the third string, first fret. Third string, first fret.
Okay.
And I'm going to strum all six strings. So in this case, I have to lift my right-hand thumb. I'm not resting my thumb over here. I'm going to brush all six. Let me do it a sec so you can have an idea of what it's going to sound like. That's an E7.
Oh, no, I'm not doing it right. What am I doing wrong?
I need to see your hand more... So we'll just go over it here. I'll just go over again where to place your fingers.
Okay.
I think your second finger needs to be on the fifth string.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah.
Good
okay.
work, the good way to go, exactly. And then the first finger needs to be on the third string, first fret.
Okay.
Now strum all six. Now, it could be your guitar's out of tune.
Okay. I just had it strung, so
So when you put new strings on, they tend to stretch a little bit. Now, okay. Classical or nylon string guitars stretch like crazy, but steel strings do a little bit.
And these are steel.
So let's check your tuning, okay? I'll play my string, you play your string.
Okay.
First string. Good. Second string.
It's a little bit
flat. So go to your second peg, which is over here. Then gently, I always get this screwed up. It's like I'm dyslexic, but you know, when it comes to tuning, gently turn your peg to the
righty tighty, lefty loosey.
That's right. We'll try that. So gently turn it to the right. Let me hear it.
Okay, let me see.
Good job. You went past it. You even went past it a little bit.
Okay. All right, one more time. Do yours first so I can hear. It's close.
It's good. It's very good. Let's go to third string. Close enough for us. Let's go to fourth string. Bring that up. You're very close, so just bring it up a little skosh, a teeny. So hang on. That one is this peg here, fourth string there.
Okay.
And you're going to turn it very tiny little bit. So righty tighty. You're turning it the wrong way.
Okay. More.
Sure. Close enough for us. Close enough for jazz. Okay. Give me your fifth string A. And it's just a tiny bit flat. I think because they're new, they're stretching. And it could be your sixth string is the bad one. So just the next one is the fifth string, this one here. And we're going to gently turn it. Bring it up. So you're going to turn it this way. Pretty good. Let's hear the sixth string. That's the culprit. It's definitely flat. So you want to go to your this peg here.
Okay. Yes,
and gently turn it, tighten it up. Yeah, you're good. You're good. And you went past it. You can hear. I can tell you've got a good ear. You went past it.
Yeah.
Go back down a little bit. Do it one more time. That's pretty good. So, by the way, here's a couple of tips for people tuning. You're usually better off going below a note and coming up to it, rather than if you tighten the string, it won't loosen on its own. But if you loosen it, it might. I mean, it could, you know, loosen a little bit on its own. You follow? But if you're tightening it, it tends to stay there. So.
Yep.
Sometimes you want to go below the note and then come up is actually more effective than just loosening it, and then you find, hey, it slipped. That's all.
Yeah.
So let me play for a minute and show you where I'm going with these chords.
Okay.
And then I'm going to talk a little more about my handout and some of the things you can do and some resources. So we've looked at the A7 chord. And again, if you had that handout, I was hoping I could share the screen. I guess I could hold this up in front of the, somehow prop it up in front of the camera.
I can't see it.
Oh, it's going to be about the size of a postage stamp, right? So, A7, D7, and E7. And what happens there, we can combine that. So what you want to do with chords, here. Whatever your chords are, when you start going, you know, chords live together in a key. Have you had any music theory?
No.
Anyway, okay. So what happens is if you, and I love music theory, but we could go down a rabbit hole here. let me put it this way. If I play a G scale, I'm going to start on a G note and go do, re, mi. And I have scales. I'll mention some of my resources since I'm doing this. I have something called In Scales in Tablature on my handout. Now, you don't need to read the notes. You can look at tabs or tablature. And what tablature is, it's really old. Anything with frets is written in tablature. So I have some scales in tablature. Okay, so let's say the bars 3 and 4 are a G scale. And the main chords in that key are G, C, D, 7, G. So chords are built on notes of the scale. There's a pattern, a system at work. And it's not a set of rules that somebody came up with. Music theory is an explanation after the fact, meaning it exists like this. You could know nothing and still play great music because your ear tells you what to do. So the theory explains it, but you don't need to know it, but it helps you if you know it, because then you can play things that are in a key or exist together in a sense, in a music, in a way that sounds like music, not random. It's not random. That's the whole point. So if I play a G scale, real quick here, and I'll show you how to read tablature real quick. Okay, I have a page in here actually about reading tablature that I took from a great resource I found called Guitar Tutor Online. There's millions of things out there now, web pages, everybody has their, you know, system. I thought this was good because it had very nice, clean and clear examples, samples, and even sound clips. And again, you know, they'd like you to sign up for lessons or something, which is great, but the stuff they have available for free is very cool. So tablature is 6 lines. It's not music. In the guitar, we have 6 strings. It's this simple. 6 strings, 6 lines. The numbers on the lines represent the fret. So here's an example. It says 013. So it means open first string, first fret, first string, third fret.
Yep.
So, you know, people think it's the finger number for your left hand, but it isn't, because it could be 10, 11, 12. And if you've got 12 fingers on your left hand, you're going to get an awful lot of hits on YouTube. So the fret, the numbers on the tablature are the fret number. That's all. And what's nice about tablature is it can show you where to place your fingers. You can hear an example. This is where it helps to have a recording to access. And then you can go, oh, great. I see what to do. I hear what to do, and I can physically go and do it. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's where you could go back to my scale page once you figure that out and play my G scale here. And it's 2 octaves, so it's this. Just bear that in your ear. Listen. G, A, B, C, D. So the primary chords in the key of G, and it says it next to my scales, are G, A, B, C, and D7. So if you go and learn G, C, which is a hard chord, D7, and G, da ba 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 ba, it makes musical sense. And what I hope to give you in my handout, there's another page with chord progressions. So you can work these chord progressions. I don't know if you can see those, but and they're all 4 bars long, except for the 12 bar blues, which is at the bottom here, which we're going to do in a minute. But if you can drill yourself on these chord progressions, then when you go to play a song that you might find the chords on the internet, you've already kind of worked the chords a bit, you know. So that's all. There's just things you can do to get yourself ready to play. And you don't practice them randomly, because they don't exist randomly in music. You want to play them together. That's the big thing. And it can help to play a scale to kind of get that in your head if you want to improvise or compose anything like that. So our song is a 12-bar blues. I'm going to run you through this, even though I'm afraid. You can find this on the internet all over the place. The last 2 lines, 12-bar blues in A. So if we look at it, it's got 4 bars, and each bar is going to be 4 strums. I'm going to strum 4 times, 1, 2, 3, 4. Most music is in what we call 4-4 time. So I'm going to play 4 strums of each bar, 4 bars of A7, 2 bars of D7, back to 2 bars of A7. My last 4 bars, I'm going to play all 4 of those chords, 1 bar each, E7, D7, A7, E7, and then I want to end on an A7 or go back to an A7, the last two bars of a blues is called a turnaround, and it kind of makes you don't stop now, but go back to the beginning. It leaves you hanging. So you have to finish the song. In music, we say it needs to resolve. It needs to go back to the beginning. So you always need to end where you started on a chord progression or a song. You know. So I'm going to run through this 12-bar blues kind of quick. How are we doing on time? And then you can start trying to play that at home. And I'll also give you a few other tips on what I got here. Okay, I wish I could hold this up while I play it. Maybe I can.
Stop it. I'll watch.
While other people are looking too, they might be on a big computer. I need a box. Hadn't thought about this. Like I said, I was hoping to share. You can share your screen on Zoom, but it's not really set up. If I put this on here, is it going to make my computer fall down? Ooh, can you see that?
So yeah.
Here I go. You're going to see me. Well, wait, yeah, you kind of do need to see me too, I guess. Well, let me play it anyway. Three, from the A7, four bars. Three, four. One bar. Second bar. Third bar. Fourth bar. Now I'm going to D7. Back to A7. Two, three, four. Last four bars. E7, D7, A7, E7, and end on A. So that's the 12-bar blues, which is a great American art form. You know, it's the original. I mean, a lot of music, you know, came from other countries, but the blues are American. And, you know, so it's a simple, fun way to start playing. And let me mention one thing on this. So I put on the last four bars, there's a couple of chords in parentheses. If you wanted to leave those out, you could. And you could just play the last four bars, two bars E7, two bars A7. It's simpler. If you want to practice this blues and you get the PDF, work the last four bars. Because if you can do that, playing four bars of A7 is easy. What's hard is switching between the chords. It's not holding the chord. That's tricky initially. It's switching. So that's the 12-bar blues. And so I have various chord progressions there. Let me talk a little bit about my PDF because I'm hoping you can pick it up. And you've got my name. I'm the only Julian Catford on the planet, actually. There is a suburb of London called Catford, and I'm probably related to that somehow way back because I'm actually from Edinburgh originally, but I've been in this country many years. And let me see if I can share a few things. I can't really tell how this is working. You know what might work if I turn off the overhead light and then there's no glare. See, tell me if this is any better. Not really.
Okay. Yep, a little bit better.
So I've got a chord chart. I'm going to kind of flip through some of my junk. Ah, this is really good. This is a chart of different picking and strumming patterns. Now, here's the important thing here. It's more what the right hand does than what the left hand does. The left hand makes a chord shape. You can make any one of those chords that we remember, and then you can try playing these different patterns. My example is on a C chord, but it doesn't have to be a C chord. So this is where, I can't play and hold the thing at the same time. Problem, Houston. Anyway, I'll play a couple of these patterns. You got on the A7 chord that we just did. The root or bass note is the fifth string, so the second pattern is what I call boom chuck, and what you do is you play, thumb plays a bass note, and then you strum down the rest of the chord, so it's like bass, strum. And you can do that on any chord. You know, D7, the bass note is D, the fourth string. And on my E7, the bass note is the sixth string E. That's pattern two there. Boom, chuck, boom, chuck. Each one being a beat, each bar being four beats. You could go boom, chaka, which is on A7, bass, down, up. Now, on the upstroke, it's maybe two or three strings. It's not the whole chord. That's important. So it's this. Okay, so I have some picking patterns for the right hand there. Let me mention one other thing before we run out of time. I really don't want to run out of time. I want to, on the first part of my handout, I have a document sort of with text that you could read that has some of these tips and things to remember. Okay. I do want to thank the Rainier Ave Radio folks, the City of Seattle, and the Seattle Musicians Association, Local 76433, for sponsoring this and also putting it together, especially Rainier Radio. They are wonderful for doing this, and it is a great service that they do. So, one last thing. I'm holding a guitar pick, okay? Just so you can strum with your finger, and lots of folks play with a pick. You want to get a teardrop-shaped pick. You hold it in your right hand. Here's the trick. Make sure your wrist is straight in the right hand. And we're going to clamp the pick on the end of our first finger digit and the thumb. And the pick is at 90 degrees to my arm. That's what you want to make sure. And you get a firm grip, not over tight, but not too loose and kind of wimpy so it flies out of your hand. But not so hard that your hand cramps up, right? And the other things, people, you want to make sure you tuck that finger out of the way so you don't hit your fingers when you strum with the pick. That's all. And you hold it about halfway down, okay? So it's not at the very end, and it's not where there's hardly any, you know. And if you want a medium pick for a beginner, yes, somebody might like super thin where it flaps and flexes for strumming. Somebody might like super fat for gypsy jazz or certain styles of metal music. They want to have certain control. But for a beginner, just a regular pick, great, and a regular shape, you know. So if I strum my A7.
All right. Looks like we are out of time here, Julian. But before we go, we do have a listener question. Where can we get that PDF?
Well, I have talked to one of your folks, and he said, Asher said that you guys will put it up on your website. Is that correct or not? Do you know?
I can't confirm or deny that at this point.
Okay. Well, you can look up me up. I'm the only Julian Catford. If you email me, I'll be happy to email it to you. Okay. I spent some time putting it together, and I would like people to get it. And if it helps you, great. Yeah.
What's the name of that website?
It's my name, Julian Catford, right there on the screen. I see Julian Catford. Do you see Julian Catford?
No.
Oh, okay.
.com?
Yes. JulianCatford.com. I'm all over the web as far as wanting to play gigs. I've done jazz, classical, Latin music, weddings, corporate events. So if you just punch my name in, you'll find me eventually.
All right. Thank you, Julian, for your guitar lessons.
Thank you. Thank you. Good luck with it all.
Thank you so much. Bye.
We're going to change things up just a little bit for you all on our Make Music Seattle live stream going on until 9 p.m. Pausing the music lessons here for a second. As we, in just a couple of minutes here, we're going to go live on the waterfront to the One Love Waterfront Marching Band. So keep it with us right here on Rainier Avenue Radio, which you can listen in on our Facebook live stream currently going on right now, RainierAvenueRadio.world Facebook page, on the RainierAvenueRadio.world app, and on our website, RainierAvenueRadio.world.